And then there were eight in the FCS playoffs. And tomorrow afternoon, the SDSU football team will try to return to the FCS semifinals for the fourth time as the Jackrabbits hit the road to take on the Wildcats of Villanova in the FCS quarterfinals. Hi, friends. Tyler Merriam, and welcome to Gameday Eve. Should be a dandy tomorrow between SDSU and Villanova. Let's briefly recap how the Jackrabbits arrived here. A 24-19 victory over Sacramento State in round two. SDSU, the only unseeded team to go on the road and win in round two last week. The Jacks dominated early. Had a 24-0 lead late in the second quarter. Then the Hornets rallied to score the final 19 points, but SDSU able to hold off the home team with a little fourth down trickery in the final minute and a half to seal the deal. Don Gardner, Cade Tervier each came up with interceptions. Matter of fact, they both have picked off a pass in each of the two playoff games. SDSU did not turn the football over. Sacramento State's two turnovers, both coming in SDSU territory. One turned back the Hornets at the goal line. The other led to an SDSU score, so pivotal plays in that football game. Chris Oladokun was very good on Saturday. Didn't make any huge mistake. Few times had to get rid of the football because of pressure. He was 12 of 23 for 158 yards. That doesn't really tell the story. He also had that 27-yard nifty quarterback scramble, his longest run from scrimmage in his year as a Jackrabbit. Isaiah Davis, another 100-yard game in the postseason, 19 carries for 108 and a couple of scores. Pierre Strawn Jr. runs for 73 yards and a score on 14 attempts. You want to talk about how good those two have been when all the chips are pushed to the center of the table in the playoffs. Isaiah Davis has now played six playoff games. He has rushed for 771 yards, 10 yards per carry, and nine touchdowns in the postseason. And of those 77 rushes, 19 of them have gone for 10 or more yards, 11 of them for 20 or more, six of them for 30 or more. But Strong is no slouch either. He's played nine playoff games. He's rushed for 851 yards and six touchdowns during his career in the postseason. And 22 times he has had a carry in the playoffs of 10 or more yards, nine times 20 or more, four times 30 or more. Those two are something else. And the Jacks will need them tomorrow afternoon out in suburban Philadelphia as they take on the Wildcats of Villanova, the champions of the Colonial Athletic Association. Nova just two losses all season. This is the 14th time that the Nova program has gone to the FCS playoffs. Second time in the last 3 years. They have a ton of pedigree. Longtime coach Andy Talley led that program to a national championship back in 09. You'll remember Talley's last game was an SDSU 10-7 win over Villanova in the only previous meeting between these two programs. That was in round two of the 2016 playoffs. Now it is Mark Ferrante who was leading the charge, former assistant to Talley, now the head coach, the CAA Coach of the Year. And when you talk Villanova, you talk defense. Third in the nation in total defense, seventh nationally in passing defense, 10th nationally against the run, 13th best in the country on third downs getting off the field, and they have the 7th best scoring defense in the FCS. Mainly a 3-3-5. They don't have a whole lot of gimmicks. It's a base defense, and as John Stiglmeyer says, if they execute a defense and it works, they may run that same defense 3-4-5-6 plays in a row. That's how good and talented they are and how simplistic in some ways that they are. If they need to be complicated, they can be, but when simple works, why go above and beyond, right? It all starts with Forrest Ryan, linebacker, the CAA Defensive Player of the Year, 131 tackles this year. That's the 11th most of any FCS player, and he had 21 last week as Villanova survived a scare at home against Holy Cross in the second round. His fellow linebacker, who wears 29, Amin Black, 85 tackles, second most on the team, and he leads the squad in tackles behind the line of scrimmage. He's made 12 stops for loss. If you talk about the defensive line, 92 Malik Fisher would be the leader there, four sacks on the year. He had five stops in the Holy Cross victory in round two. And if you go back to the secondary, cornerback Christian Befford is a first-team All-CAA selection, six pass breakups and two interceptions in the last three games. He leads the country in passes defensed. We flip to the offensive side of the ball for Villanova. This is an offense that statistically isn't overly flashy, but it is certainly effective. They do rack up 380 yards per game, which nationally isn't all that impressive. It's 45th, but it's second best in the CAA, that very much a defensive-minded league. They average 175 on the ground, 204 through the air. The offense, though, I talk about being efficient. 45 trips in the red zone. They've scored on 42 of those. In fact, they've scored 32 touchdowns in 45 red zone trips. And in each of the last 19 times they have ventured into the red zone, the Nova offense has scored. You have to go back a good 7 weeks to find the last time Villanova had an empty red zone trip. Michael Corby is a first-team All-CAA selection at left guard. He leads an offensive line that is big. Every starter's at least 6'3". Every starter's over 300 pounds. They've only allowed 12 sacks all year. At running back, it starts with two different men. Number one, Justin Covington. Number 36, Jalen Jackson. Both average over 6 yards per carry. They have a combined 13 rushing touchdowns. Quarterback is Daniel Smith. We talk about how not overly flashy. You look at the numbers, only 54% completions. Matter of fact, he's been below 50% completions 5 times in 11 games, including each of the last three. But he is certainly effective, 22 touchdowns to 9 interceptions. He's thrown for nearly 2,300 yards. You talk about Smith's weapons. At wideout, number 11, Jaron Hayek has caught 37 balls. Number 19, Rajon Pringle is the deep threat, 36 catches, one shy of Hayek's total, but he's averaging 20 yards per catch. And they like to use the tight end, number 86, Todd Summers, 24 grabs, 3 for scores. That's the offense, their special teams unit, very accurate kicking, very good in punting, had a huge kick return last week against Holy Cross that kind of turned things back in Villanova's way after the Crusaders had scored 10 straight points to open up the third quarter. One thing to keep an eye on, actually two things you're going to want to keep an eye on in this game, penalties and turnovers. Bit of a dust statement, but a little more into the specifics of that. The most penalty yards in the CAA have gone to Villanova. Third most in the Missouri Valley have gone to South Dakota State. So both teams have had times where penalties have hurt them. Turnovers, the other big factor. SDSU's been so good as of late in winning the turnover battle. I mentioned +2 against Sacramento State for the year. The Jacks are +16. Nova's +7 on the year in their only FCS loss, and that was back to William and Mary. They threw 4 interceptions. So both teams, in a game like this where you expect low-scoring, stingy defenses, you have to take care of the football. Can't shoot yourself in the foot either with penalties or with turnovers. Villanova Stadium, beautiful facility nestled into a very wealthy part of Philadelphia. It's a lovely campus. Looking forward to seeing it this weekend. It seats right around 12,500 people, track around the facility, but it isn't this huge gawking stadium. It's built kind of low to the ground, so it really is neat. Been around for over 90 years. That will be the site of tomorrow's FCS quarterfinal round matchup. Kickoff at 1 p.m. Central Time. Our radio coverage starts at noon throughout the Jackrabbit Sports Network or the exclusive video coverage via ESPN+. SDSU and the 5th seed Villanova in the quarterfinals of the FCS playoffs. It all gets started with kickoff tomorrow afternoon at 1 p.m. Central.